Well, it's time for the Neil Haley Show. Is one thing I told you guys when I talked to you guys the last couple of outings is that the Total Education Hour is no more. Last week we had the Total Education Hour. This show is kind of a reminisce. I'm waiting on Jarrett calling me. For 9 years of radio and television, I have a lot of stories, and I can tell the stories in this hour, trust me, as I was shedding a tear with Jason, the public school guy, 1 week ago. And really, I think this is one of the roughest year the Neil Haley Show Total Education Network has had. It's been a lot of ups and downs and bumps and bruises. We've had some amazing guests this year, but at the end of the year, we kind of pulled the plug on certain things. But I trust you people, and I trust everyone out there, ladies and gentlemen, that 2019, the 10th year, we're going to do some special things. I'm not going to sit here idle and give up on what I've built in the stories. One of the stories, I guess, if I can add the first story, would be syndication. One of the biggest addictions I have to get to 130 plus stations is syndication. And at one point before, I had a team of people, I would never have thunk it, that were funding and doing different things. I was up to 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the morning, and then going to school and teaching after trying to get everything done. Falling asleep in the chair in the same studio that I am tonight on December 27th. Falling asleep, waiting on things, and saying, okay, what's going on here? What's going to happen next? And I think it was like these little vignettes I was doing, and they were a lot of fun. And I'm like, make sure to get those uploads, make sure I could edit those shows, make sure I could find syndication. We worked really hard. And that's one thing that, you know, if I would pull the plug on a bit, two businesses I own right now for our listeners out there, the Total Tutor education business, which I'd say, I guess we're going to call it Total Tutoring soon at one point, has been around for over that time period, probably 13, 14 plus years. And now I guess Total Media Marketing, which kind of stemmed from education to that, has been around 3 or 4 or 5 years. To pull the plug on that, if other opportunities were coming, like the security business, the insurance business, the every business in between, I'm trying to look at as an entrepreneur for 2019. But this right here is something that's passionate. It's something that makes me really have this just absolute tremendous desire to do. It's fun. It's been a fun 9 years of let's kind of do a mathematical first thing about sleeping. What about the number of interviews? As again, I said, we've slowed down in 2018. The clip levels of some weeks, 15 to 16, some days, 15 to 16 people. So let's do the math. After the first year, we started doing 7 days a week. So the best estimate is, let's say we did an average in 9 years of 10 people a week for 52 weeks, never took off time, 450 people a year, maybe more. Let's say 500 people for 9 years, 500 people. And I think that's a low estimate of 500 people, interviews a year. The total number is 4,500 people. Now, would I think that that number of only 400 to 500, some days we did 20. I mean, we have to get a counter out there, because like I said, there are weeks, there's outlier weeks of only 3 or 4 interviews, or during the holiday time where we kind of slow down things. So I guess the best estimate to look at probably is almost 5,000 interviews. Because when we did the Miami Book Fair, I clipped 30 or 32 in one day, or in one weekend. So I'll go with that number. I'll go with the number of about 5,000 interviews. Number of shows, 7 days a week. Average, and so, you know, a little different, 7 days a week, 7 shows a week for a certain time, 5 shows a week. Well, seven, some years we took in numbers of almost 350 shows a year. So it's quite an interesting journey. It's a journey that I'll never forget in so many ways. Jarrett knows showing me brings out stories, but how do I feel as a human being after of what I've accomplished? 5,000 interviews. 10th year is going to be something special. I'll continue in that promotion end as I'm going to take a sip of my coffee going live and talking for 1 hour with you people. Uh-oh, I broke a rule right now. But, I mean, it's going to be exciting next year, and the plans are great. But let's kind of look at things in this maturation process of growth. I told stories with Jason. Jason only knew half the story because there's a lot more to it than the Total Education Hour. There sure is a heck of a lot more to it than the radio in general. There is BPTV, which has its own storybook with Dave Cable and the story of Dave Cable. So how can I not repeat myself? Let's go with things that were not around with Jason. We talked about the addiction that I had with Blog Talk Radio. But one of the things I do is I constantly envision myself. I constantly look at things. And I said, man, you know what? I'm in this studio at WRCT. I want a television show. I want someone to film in the studio. Let's get on TV. It was one of my goals because a lot of these things, the creation that I created, were dreams I had as a professional wrestler that I took on before anybody else had the Stone Cold podcast. We're going even back further. Or anyone had wrestling talk shows that Stefan Devereaux, Aaron Lester, and I created. He was the creator of the Devereaux Committee. I was a producer with him at the Devereaux Committee. I should call him right now to get him on the show right now to talk about this. But literally, I had this envision that I was going to have over 500 TV stations and no radio. We weren't even thinking radio. 500 TV stations across the country cable access to carry the Devereaux Committee. And I was the main man that was going to do it. We were calling different stations and different stories. It was years ago, trust me, ladies and gentlemen. And it doesn't seem like it was long ago, but that was it. And I had this dream. So when I said, okay, I started with radio first. This is kind of the cart before the horse. I want television. Television's the biggest thing. So let's film in the studio. Let's do what Howard Stern did. Let's show where the magic took place. So I hired one of my tutors to go ahead and try to do a TV show. And so and now when I tell you where the TV show goes in the 10th year anniversary, it's a quite different animal in 10 years. Trust me, 10 years changes a lot. I can imagine the next 10 years because I am not giving this up. I'm not going to give this up anyway. I'm not fighting because we have this next season, the amazing opportunity to have probably the best programming out there next year. I'll continue to talk about this because I really am excited about 2019 in many aspects, but for sure that we are positioning ourselves with some great programming after a year I bought an internet radio station. So I have a lot of stories, trust me. So let's go back to this one. So I had Christine and I at Etherington, who was one of my tutors, to come and film the show. She filmed it, but gosh, you know, she's a filmmaker. Oh, she can edit, right? Wrong. She knew how to film it. Yay. Think about these days. But could not edit it to be TV broadcast ready. So I put an ad on Craigslist. I think it was Craigslist. I put out an ad and it's Craigslist basically asking, I am looking for a television producer and for someone to edit the radio show and the TV show and how much would it cost? And so many people came through and Dave Cable out of nowhere from Bethel Park says, hey, I'll do it for you for free. I'm like, what? Are you kidding me? You're going to do it for free? And that started the process of television. And like every project that I have, sometimes these projects take a back burner and they don't really kind of develop and grow and develop. But thank goodness, Dave Cable in the 10th year is going to be highlighted tremendously. who knows what's going to happen in 2019 when it comes to BPTV Channel 7 in Bethel Park. You can pick it up anywhere. And again, on YouTube with my 10,000 subscribers. But that's another story. Like I said, I have in an hour stories that I did not tell last week. Again, on the Neil Haley Show. Connect with me on Twitter at Total Tutor. And you might say, well, why are we hearing these stories? Because I want to give some people these you podcasters, you want to be radio show hosts, to understand what 10 years means, understand what stories mean. And they're all popping my head. So Dave Cable came out of nowhere and said, yeah, I'll do it. And we did he filmed. We had someone filming in the studio, maybe four or five. They're still available on one of our stations. You can go back and check me out when I kind of was younger looking. I don't think I've aged in 10 years, but you got to tell me that story as well, or 9 years. But you could see it, and you could see what the studio was like at RCT. At one point, it stopped. We stopped doing this, and Dave and I had a conversation, and Neil's like, Neil, what are you going to do? Well, I'm going to go to Bethel Park, and we're going to film a show. And lo and behold, we did it. Begin Total Education with Neil. One of another proven shows where I came into the studio, and Jarrett would come to the studio because Jarrett loved television. But I had a co-host, Dr. Somebody. I can't remember. She's a huge star. So I apologize if I forget her name. I brought up a little bit of that story. She went to WQED. Now she's like one of the greatest parenting experts in the world. And I applaud her for her success. One of the things I like to talk about every time, and people that have touched my lives and life in 9 years, if they have greater success than me, I'm happy for them because hopefully something rubbed off on them from my experience working with people like Jerry the King Lawler, Burt Prentice, the Bushwhackers, the Spiders, whoever I crossed paths with in professional wrestling. And in the entertainment field that I was in, and in my years of producing, to give some sort of nuggets and provide a professional show for them to get their first break. And I forget her name. It'll come to me in a second. We're friends on Facebook, but that's not the story. The story is we did Total Education with Neil. We did some really good shows. We brought some people in with guests. But we're sticking to education. And remember, I'm on a different path at times during that, but it was a lot of fun. You know, get up, go into the studio. I'd love to maybe get back to that, but trust me, with my new schedule and all these different things, that's not happening many times soon. Maybe I can convert this into a studio at one point and we could do radio and television. I already got some great ideas in 2019. Again, my brain starts moving and that's grooving. So we did the television show. It went from the Total Education Neil to Neil Haley Show, did a lot of stuff with Coach Hall, did a lot of shows, a lot of fun shows, a lot of fun celebrities walked into the studio, local ones, and a lot of fun interviews in X amount of years, and then that kind of stopped. But I kept staying on Bethel Park. I send my show out to them on a regular basis, or our top celebrity interviews or wherever he puts together an hour show, and the Neil Haley Show will continue to be on in Bethel Park. So that was one of my stories. And if you have any questions on the story or comments, you can write to me and ask questions. But I don't think that Jarrett stayed up, and that's sad, and I'm disappointed. But he didn't. But I could continue with stories, but that one with Bethel Park's great. It's great to have a television station. I'm going to tell you right now, thank you, BPTV Channel 7. I have three unbelievable milestone people. Of broadcasters, Blog Talk Radio, WRCT, and Bethel Park Community Television. Bethel Park allows me to get major guests in relationships with the drop of a hat. Thank goodness I have television. And it's helped me get some major stars. I mean major stars. And it's great to have because of trying to fight the whole, what's your audience, what syndication do you have, what do you have, to throw in, hey, you're more on television as well. That's a huge, huge power. So I wanted to tell you that story because that's another one of the stories. The stories kind of are endless. That one involves television. I have some interesting stories about TV. I made some crazy days where I did 8 or 9 interviews in the television studio, and all that stuff's available. The number of interviews, again, will be a question to bring back. So Jason and I were talking a lot about the history of the education show. But there was a lot more to the whole syndication story that I did not talk about on the program last week. And it again shows, it attests to my fortitude, not my talent, my fortitude to never give up. And the roller coaster ride of 9 years has been a roller coaster. At times I'm done with celebrities. At times I'm done with education. I'm done with this. I'm done with that. And lo and behold, some of these things continue to stay. Or I'm done with radio. I don't have time to do radio. This is too much on my plate. And then I'm back grinding it out again. So it's the process of what I've done in my life. And it's a roller coaster ride, but it's something that you can't believe. And so just to talk about today at 45 years old, going on 46, if I want to talk about my career accomplishments in the entertainment field, let's not talk about home. Let's not talk about any of these other things. Let's just talk about accomplishments in life, in professional entertainment. I was a professional wrestler for over 9 years, number 500 wrestler in the world, retired at a time where I didn't get injured, was able to produce a television show and produce a radio show and get to learn the business from behind the camera, in front of the camera, get to edit and all that stuff. Then was able to go on to a show, which a syndicated network of 9 years, interviewed major celebrities, got to meet major people, had major doors open and all these different things. What a life. Got to play college basketball. Got to have the opportunities to really do some amazing things. This is talks about entertainment career. There's nothing, if we're going to ever go any further, getting the opportunity to go to New York City, being one of the media that's pitched, getting the opportunity to be walk into different places, hotels, interview Dinah Dallas Page, to going ahead and opening up doors into different films and getting free tickets to different films and different Harlem Globetrotters, all these different things. I mean, I can't even imagine the amazing things that I've done, from the Civic Light Opera to getting VIP passes to different things, to being at the whatever the Atlantic 10 or whatever the tournaments are called. All these opportunities and doors opening where I can walk in and I'm media. Wow. I never imagined that day I walked into WRCT Studios that I would have all that. Okay. So right now, whatever happens in this 10th year, anything in my entertainment, if I walk away tomorrow, I have accomplished everything I've set my mind to so far and more. Am I going to say this is over? We have some huge goals in 2019. You're not going to tell me, but I told you this roller coaster ride, some amazing experiences. I might even forget some of those experiences. And I talk about in professional wrestling, the same kind of experiences. And me walking back into the ring in 2019, it's still a possibility. I'm out of shape again. Sorry, folks. So I'll have to talk about my get back in shape again. Some life hits you. Life happens. And I'm back gained the weight again. I guess thanks to the winter conference over at Lensec, but that it is what it is. So let me go right from here to the stories as I talked about in syndication. Syndicated radio is an animal it's over now. It's syndication is a great, I'm 130 plus stations, 3 million listeners a week, viewers a week, social media reach of 3 million people. Wow. Great numbers, right? But the whole process, the whole kit and caboodle is, how did I get syndication? I told you, as a college radio station, got on Blog Talk Radio, and I want to start booking guests. And now we got to talk about the special guests part of this feature. We have so many stories. I want to go back to so many people that have touched my life in 9 years. And this is one thing about the 10th year, from different educating guests, all these. I love to highlight all of them on my platforms. That's something a lot of re-airs might happen, but it's such great content. We can do it again. Look at me. I just decided I'm going to do a show tonight. I just felt like it. Jarrett said, hey, are you going to do a show? I wanted to do a show to end 2018 on the note, and I said, well, let's grab a mic and let's go. But okay, so I was in one station, Blog Talk Radio, let's say two stations, and I got a phone call. Hey, Brian Kress, special guests. He booked me some of the most amazing guests. Again, got to go back to the archives. Best thing is probably subscribe at the podcast. 9 years covered. Every show under the sun has aired on that. We can go back to syndication later. There's a lot of things kind of drawing to find different things, but go back to 2010 and look at the beginning phases, 2009 and 2009 and 2009, 2010, and look at some of the shows and look at when Brian Kress immediately first guest came through, some lady, Fran Silverman. Franny gave me a guest that wrote some book, and what the heck it was, who knows? And I said, well, I wanted more. I remember I told you the story about the education, because we had to kind of have Jason involved in these stories. So I did that. Okay. I went ahead and did that whole deal. Right. Okay. Boom, boom, boom. And we move right forward. Okay. Let's kind of move forward. Let's take our little step ahead. Let's take a little bit of a, you know, one step, two step over, a one, two step over. And we're walking right into, guess what, ladies and gentlemen? We're walking into new guests. I want to find guests. I want guests on my show. But how to book guests for your show. And special guests came. I'm like, really? What? There's somebody who's going to get me a guest every week. You don't understand how that, I mean, or 7 days a week. I said, holy cow, he can get me guests any night to come on my radio show? Are you kidding me? And this guy did it. Brian Kress would pull people out of the woodwork. And like I said, we could highlight any of these guys, make it a full-fledged feature, and it would be something interesting. As we talked about Dr. Carey and the psychic thing last week on the show. So Brian Kress and special guests and Jerry, Jerry McLaughlin, Jerry, again, another person. And that's another stories that we're going to kind of talk about tonight. He has had something to do with this network as well. There are a lot of people that have kept this on the air for 9 years, from GJ Reynolds funding me, GJ and Simply G Media Network, to so many volunteers that just came out, took their time and effort to be on this show, where I'm sitting today with probably the best opportunity to make the most money with the Neil Haley Network that I have never made in radio. I mean, I've had spurts, but this one could be the best. And the best opportunity, one of the biggest shows that's going to really grow leaps and bounds. And the opportunities with some of these other programs, this will be the first time in radio that there'll be a profit, not a negative, even though it helps my business grow tremendously, that we're very excited. And we're going to really kind of touch more base on what's going to happen and everything in 2019, but not on tonight's anniversary show. But as I said, I'm on Brian Kress booking people. And Brian says, you need to syndicate. I got a great syndicator. Let me introduce you to him. So he introduces me. He's Phoenix Broadcasting Network, still one of my syndicators. And I got to reach out to him. Seriously, this is the fun thing about this, is anybody that I have met in my years in radio and television, I want to go back and reintroduce myself to them again. Hey, I'm Neil Haley. How are you? Because, again, I'm so gung-ho rolling through with celebrity every second that I kind of forgot a lot of the people that were such interesting stories. I mean, my stories can go on and on. But okay, so I meet the guy from Phoenix Broadcasting. He gets me Life Improvement Radio as my one syndicated station. I'm so excited. Eric Remmel, and Eric and I are still buddies today. That's how Eric and I have done the Miami Book Fair for X amount of years. And again, you can go to lifeimprovementmedia.com or just Google search Miami Book Fair Life Improvement Radio. I think it'll come to me in a second what the station is. I just want to promote Eric Remmel. Just Google that and find 9 years. 9 years. Again, another thing. I think it was eight. 8 or 9 years of the Miami Book Fair, all available there, because Eric and I have done it live for 9 years. It's a great accomplishment. It's one of those great stories. But Eric started the syndication. And the sad thing, in this, the story does not end well with Phoenix Broadcasting. And you know, this is the problem. All the people I've paid, at one point I run out of money. I wish I could keep them all, but this guy's a great guy, Phoenix Broadcasting. I mean, he gave me Life Improvement Radio. We thought more stations were coming. None of them came. And I told him, brother, you gave me one station, that's not enough, and I let him go. And did I give up? This is the other story. Did I give up? Did I say, okay, I lost that syndicator. There's no way in heck. I got Life Improvement Radio. It's increased my listening base. I'm so excited to be part of Life Improvement Radio. And that's enough for me, right? I give up. No, I always persevere. I always just say, you know what? This is not, I'm not giving up. No way, no how. I can't give up. It's kind of reminding myself of walking out of Bremen, Germany, and just giving up in wrestling. Is there regrets? And thank goodness with the deaths and everything, and now how wrestling's a lot safer, especially if I decide to do what I want to do and get back in the ring at 46 years old next year. Well, I've not said if that's going to happen or not. That's just that's a thought. If I'm too busy and working on making more money, I'm not going to do it. But yeah, that was a tough time. So I went over to LinkedIn, joined a bunch of groups, and I got a lot of syndication, and it got really exciting. Terrestrial stations to WSDI Chicago, which we're still on Wednesdays, to be on in Chicago, Cyber Station USA, thanks to Brian Kress. And the syndication kept going and going to this one station in Delaware, to just different stations. I just kept picking up stations and trying to work and find them. And we kept growing and growing and growing and growing as we are today. And that's the cool thing. That's the great thing of all this, is that we just kept growing and growing, and it was just a tremendous, tremendous, tremendous growth to where we are today. Syndication, different stations. We were on in different countries at times. We were on different countries at different times, and the battles and the different challenges. But we kept growing as an organization to where we are today, thanks to AM/FM 247 and their 15, 16 terrestrial stations. That kept us going because we were on a bunch of other ones too. If we could add all the ones that we were on in 9 years, that was a story itself. And I guess that brings to the next story at our halfway mark of the show. I went from a college radio station to a terrestrial station. College to terrestrial station, meaning this is one 50,000 watt blowtorch, and it's not KDK, but it's something like it. And I took a shot at that. And Jarrett and I together took a shot with this. And I wish he was on for that. And that's what we'll talk about now. And that really kind of put me on a map as, oh my gosh, you're on terrestrial radio. Yeah, you're on internet radio stations, but now you're finally on terrestrial radio. Not just WRCT, you're on a station, WWNL, I forget the call letters in Pittsburgh. And wow, this is exciting. Let's go. Let's get it going. So I went ahead, met with the station. It was really cool and got some great professional formation. Get to do a 30-minute show with a professional producer once a week. It was really, really, really interesting. It was really a great learning experience to learn the process. We brought different guests on. We used a lot of the syndication that we're dealing with in different ways. And we dealt with, commercials and taking breaks and all the things that podcasters don't even look at and worry about at times. We took all those different options out there and we did it. We went for it. And it was really cool. I mean, I remember just having to deal with a producer. You know, we walk into the studio, it's on top, it's no longer there, located right down the street from my house. We get in there, sit down, we know when the show's going to air, it's 30 minutes, we have 26 minutes to do it, let's go in and get out, boom, 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 and we did it. At times, I finally just edited and sent the show, but we did it, and it was really fun, and Jarrett and I had a lot of fun in the studio with whoever our guests were. And again, those, again, are another opportunities to go back and look at the archive in 9 years and say, that was a story we didn't know about the Neil Haley Show or the Neil Haley Network or the Total Education Show or whatever. That was called the Total Education Show. And what I learned from that experience that led to more syndication is again, one of the stories that I'm trying to tell you tonight, ladies and gentlemen, is that at times you're going to feel like you hit rock bottom. You're going to feel like the world is over. That door has closed and now I'm nothing. Well, I ended up adding I forget the number of stations. I think 8 to 10, maybe 6 or 8, with a backer, and that's Simply G Media, a bunch of Christian radio stations across the country, different places. I think Louisiana. It was just an unbelievable experience that the world was over when I lost it, right? I was this big time player on all these stations, and I would promote it like crazy. You want to be on that show? And I'd send out the Harrow, and that talks about how we got a lot of celebrities. And I'm like, this is just a tremendous thing. And if I would have ever known later on that this would end up becoming even more exciting, that this journey would become even more exciting than this story, I would never have thought that. And that's why, as I talk about next year, I have no idea in 10 years where we're going to be. But we're going to be somewhere. We're going to absolutely be somewhere, and it's going to be very, very exciting. So let's go back to the story. So WWNL, we were doing that, and then I met Simply G Media Network and GJ Reynolds. And GJ was a guest on my radio show, special guest. Again, go back to Jerry McLaughlin, as I talked about People Live Touch Me in Radio. And GJ and I came up with this idea to do a show and get celebrities, and it was called... we didn't do it this beach body. We called it the Beach Lifestyle Celebrity Segment at first. And it was an idea I came up with, first with him, and I've done a lot of celebrity stuff with other people since then, but it was the Beach Lifestyle Celebrity Segment with GJ Reynolds. And we interviewed interesting celebrities, and I had Marcus Reynolds booking the show. So I had someone booking my show. I talked about the days of Up All Night, and so he was booking the show, and we were having amazing guests, and he decided, hey, let's get syndication. So we picked up a lot of other stations, one in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, Alabama, Louisiana. I forget the whole entire list, but it was a pretty interesting list of radio stations we picked up, and we kept rolling. And we did it for about a year, thanks to GJ Reynolds, Simply G Media Network, funding the radio stations. So then finally, he said he's not going to fund it anymore. And I said, okay, I'm giving up all those. And then I gave up Pittsburgh. It was a hard thing to say, my gosh, I'm now not going to be on terrestrial radio. And AM/FM 247 came with Jason Dowd. And thanks to Jason, we picked up X amount of terrestrial stations. And we're bigger today than we were then. So that's another story for another time and another place that happened. And that's the interesting part of all this, if you're listening, is these stories, these amazing stories that happen thanks to something you think it's over. And I would say that was one that was pretty rough, and it didn't turn out terrible. But I learned so much from it. We did such great celebrity stuff. And I even had to shut down the celebrity thing for a second. And that's another story for another time. What other story would it say in the memories of 9 years? I think the reach the pinnacle and one of the saddest things that I had to do 3 months ago to pull the plug with. But thank goodness we work with NBC, and we're always going to be working with a big time player, and it's probably the biggest time player is NBC, and who knows who NBC could give us in 2019. So I'm not even going to talk about it. Ray Liotta, I think, was the cake. I'm still working on Howie Mandel, and I have to reach back out. And I think I have more connections in NBC, but that's the one thing that's exciting for 2019. And maybe we'll be back with these guys is Art Sears radio tour. Working with Art Sears and having this opportunity to interview major celebrities, sometimes nobodies, sometimes great shows that have somebody who's like has a little part in the show. You just never knew. And it would go in these unbelievable phases, like, holy cow, I got Super Nanny to these people from The Biggest Loser, and they were the top-notch people to, oh, I got this person. Then back up, it was like the roller coaster ride of the Art Sears radio tour, the same roller coaster ride of the Neil Haley Network, Neil Haley Show. I interviewed some major celebrities, and I've not even replayed a lot of those. And I thank Art, I guess, is another one I thank beyond belief for the opportunity. I think I might go back to him? There's a question mark that we're going to find out, and we're going to be looking at and addressing by probably January. Again, we're going to be doing the planning phases at the end of the year. We have a lot of plans, especially for the top shows that I'm going to talk about at the end of the show. One of them is UFO Disclosures. One of the things I'm really, really excited about. I'm excited about a health and wellness show, a security show. I mean, just some amazing, interesting people. And we're going to be going live. Neil Haley Show, Wednesday nights at 10 p.m. Eastern. And we're going live. And I'm talking, we're going live. We're going interaction. We're going to go big time with major celebrities, interesting guests, talk, bring back all the crew. We're going to keep going. My decision on the Total Education Hour just to go to replaying shows is because of where my focus is. I have a lot. I only have 5 hours of programming to deal with every week. I have to put the best stuff out there. So back to the story of Art. I mean, so I can't explain it. I've had bigger guests without Art, but I've had the comparison of having a Mel Brooks interviewing Mel Brooks versus interviewing somebody like, I'm trying to think here, the top of my head. I can't even think of the guests for a second, but the comparisons are amazing. To Dionne Warwick. Wow. Dionne Warwick versus Mel Brooks. To one person, that would be wow. To the other person, that. And so that's the kind of stories we have. To a lot of people that we just loved in the 80s and 90s. Honestly, I could probably book them myself. And that's the guests every week came. Well, I'd say 2 to 3 amazing every week. Some weeks, other weeks, wow, where you have 5 or 6, you're like, holy cow, did I seriously interview these people? But they were all relevant in the news today, in the news now, and it just was a tremendous experience with Art Sears Radio Tour. And there's not, and I wish that can come back to it, but I don't know. If anyone wants to co-host with me, I am offering anyone the opportunity to interview major celebrities to come in and be a money backer with me, and we can do the shows. Because here's the thing, Art Sears is not going to work with the local docals. You better be on a terrestrial radio station, or you better have syndication and terrestrial stations like me. You can't come in as a podcast and get in with a group of people of shows that I did TV with. I mean, radio with. Chicago, Los Angeles, New York. I was on tours with unbelievable people. NBC tops the cake. If I could ever just not highlight like the phone numbers and just highlight the stations I'm on in the same thing, that is an accomplishment beyond belief. But we had these great guests, these amazing guests. And do I miss it? Yes. But do I think I need to have to utilize funding something like this? As I've kind of shown you my story, every time I've landed something else. I don't know. We're working on a hip hop show as well. So there's a lot of exciting opportunities. And also I'm working with a former Cleveland Brown that's going to do work in the NFL players. So things open up again. But to close that door with Art, I don't know. But that's another thing where right now I'm sitting at 3 months saying, why did I do that? Why couldn't I keep this going? Why couldn't I just? But ultimately, I couldn't do it anymore because of how my business has grown, how my schedule's changed, and it just wouldn't work out. So those are the stories I've been telling you. The NBC experience is amazing. Some of the challenges, but let's kind of just take a step back and look at the opportunities that I had of people that passed on, interviewing people that are dead today that were tremendous people. Dee Dee Ripman and I were having this conversation. I hope Dee Dee's going to be coming on board in 2019. I'll let you know. I'll give you that update very, very soon. But we had these stories. We had these where I interviewed Alan Thicke before he passed away. I interviewed somebody Anderson. It'll come to me in a second. She passed away 1 week later. Interviewed a football player, a race car driver, some other people all passed on. And that was the last interview. That's one thing I always look at is if someone passes away or we have some sort of quote or some sort of situation, I make sure I do it. One of the things I could look at my 9 years is if you've watched a TV show or done something, I've interviewed somebody on one of those shows. And that's a cool thing. Like, I can't, that's one thing I will always, that will be the thing that I got to keep it going as, to interviewing Greg Brady just a couple months ago, booking on my own, to somebody from Revenge of the Nerds that I love beyond belief, to interviewing someone from The Nanny. shows that I loved, people that I, and I got the chance to talk to them. That's just something that, you know, you can't take away. And I always go sitting down and say, I've interviewed that person. I've done that. I've interviewed that person. I've met that person. I know that person. And that's a cool thing that, you know, you cannot be taken away. And one of the things that touched me more than ever, and I mentioned this on the show last week, was I was doing the Mind Book Fair, and one of my authors, before we got on the air, said, oh my gosh, I loved your interview with Cary Elwes from The Princess Bride. And you interviewed him amazingly. And I'm going to become a fan of yours and subscribe to your podcast. Well, that's something that I think that as entertainers, we take the most. It's not the money we make. It's the lives we touch. And hopefully I've touched a lot of lives in 9 years and have entertained people with some amazing guests. And those guests are going to keep on going, from the Rudy Rudigers to the Rocky Blyers, to the Roger Staubachs, as I said, to the Mel Brooks, to Art Rooney II, these opportunities to, as I said, Diamond Dallas Page a few times, Nancy Grace. It just goes on and on and on and on and on, these opportunities. To Biz Markie from the Fat Boys. I'm just bringing him up just because it's in my brain. To quarterbacks, Danny White of the Cowboys, also another Cowboy. Just Dwight Stone of the Steelers. I mean, these aren't the biggest names, just the ones that are coming to my head. That's something that, wow, just amazing. To where we are today, where are we going to be tomorrow? And for the heart, sweat, blood, sweat, and tears that I've gone through in 9 years, I'm not leaving these airwaves, ladies and gentlemen. I think that probably the best bet, if I wasn't crazy, would go once a week and, you know, re-air shows. But trust me, I have an idea. Again, my creative team and I, meaning my creative team, will look at the next couple days and look at what we're going to do and accomplish. How we're going to do it next year. We have some good contacts. We have some good publicists we work with, but we really have to kind of step it up in 2019 because we don't have the great art seers anymore. And we have to get some pretty good guests, but we have some great shows. But that's for later. That's some of the reminiscing that I did not talk about and the stories that I talked about in 9 years. And we talked a lot about education, but there was a lot of shows that stemmed from the Total Education Hour. The Total Education Hour was the breeding ground of X amount of different shows, segments, and opportunities. Author's Corner is one of them. And that's what led to interviewing a lot of amazing book authors, and that's why the Mind Book Fair, Author's Corner. Another one that's really interesting is the Total Education News Show, which went off the air years ago, where we just covered news, which ended up becoming the Total Education Hour at the end. Jason, the public school guy, and I would do it on Sunday nights, as we were doing 7 nights a week. So I would just keep going, and Jason and I would be that Sunday night live 11 o'clock at night show. We would just bang it out with education news. That was one show that came from that. Total Education Show, Total Education Neil, also came from the Total Education Hour, where we talked different things about education. Jarrett would provide one of the greatest tips. I want to bring back his podcasts, where we talk developmental therapy from birth to, I guess, age 7, all available on my podcast. Go back, subscribe to my podcast, listen to it forever on a day. And there's just, I mean, every show has something that you learned about. So that show, Total Education News Show, as I brought you about, Total Education Q&A. Dee Dee Rittman and I talked about that just about a couple last week, and we reminisced about Total Education Q&A, where we had great questions from parents that we answered. And we answered live with, it was not a Twitter live, it was Periscope Live. We were getting such amazing questions, and my Twitter was booming, and we were having back and forth conversations and all that stuff. Total Education Q&A, another phenomenal show. All these shows started from the Total Education Hour. At one point in time, the Total Education Hour in its first couple years had created those shows. So that's where the creative power comes into the segments. We've had great segments as well. the Just Two Choices celebrity segment, the Simply G Media Network or Beach Lifestyle celebrity segment. All, thank you, Rico, thank you. And that's, we're not done. To the Caregiver Dave celebrity segment, which we've been doing for about a year, and some amazing celebrity guests we have gotten, the Caregiver Dave celebrity segment. All of them amazing. Started out with Simply G, went to again, Just Two Choices celebrity segment, then to Caregiver Dave celebrity segment. All on the network. We did segments for education. We worked with some education powers, and I'm really excited to announce we're going to have a security segment monthly with an organization called PASS that's really going to look at protecting our schools. And I have a big security component in 2019 on the radio. So another security show could be developed and is in the works and in development. But all that came from segments. And those segments are quite interesting. Total Education Hour, we've talked about ad nauseum last week, so I don't want to even touch upon that. So we created all these different shows, different segments, to goofy segments. I can't even remember. I mean, I did some other ones that we thought, hey, this is where we're going, and it just didn't develop. I remember my marijuana segment, or my, I guess it was, I forget. It didn't work out because I just didn't have the effort or intensity to keep it going. But that was a cool segment as well. All those things, again, available on Neil Haley Network or Neil Haley Show on Twitter, wherever. Find it. You could find these amazing segments. I've done some even crazier ones involving just, I mean, who knows. But that segments were stirring the pot. So where do we go from here? And then, I mean, I might reminisce again as I'm talking for 46 minutes myself. And this is one thing I didn't have the skill set to do 9 years ago. I needed to have people. But today I've talked for 47 minutes straight, and it's been a lot of fun. Looking forward to watching Jack Ryan on Amazon right after I'm done. Love to do a segment to review different things. We've had Darnell Dinkins review different college football games. I'm remembering some of these things now as we speak about different other segments, talking about these different things. And that was great. Facebook saying hello, somebody, I guess, begging for money, I think. And I'm going to make sure I cut that person off and turn him off. And there you go. And begging for money. But that's the other story. So we... some interesting segments. I think I had a football one with an NFL player, and that went about 3, 4, 5 different segments. But where do we go from here? One thing I'm very excited about, and I have to do the edit tomorrow, is UFO Disclosures. UFO Disclosures is going to be a tremendous show. I've talked to people about it. I'm more excited about that show because of the audience that it brings and UFO Disclosures. I have Lyrically Lime that will launch in 2019. I have a wellness show that's launching in 2019. Very excited about it with CEO of a healthcare company, Larry Bradley. I have a possible security show in the works and a security segment, which is already in place with PASS. My brain is just going. A hip hop show that's in phases. I have Anthony Griggs, former NFL star for the Cleveland Browns. He's going to do a sports show on the network. So some really exciting things that are to come. And if I missed anything, I'm sorry, guys. I will come up with stuff. The Total Education Hour is going to become a podcast. Total Education Q&A is going to become a podcast. We're going to have these things available, but everyone needs to subscribe as quickly as they can. What do I think that I did not hit the mark that I wanted to hit the mark? I really wanted to get a full-fledged syndication on terrestrial stations across the country. I thought I had something very, very special with the Total Education Show and Education Show. I thought it was groundbreaking. It just did not happen. I think that terrestrial radio is dead in the water and podcasting is the wave of the future, but I also think that internet radio is the wave of the future. I wish that I had the opportunity to make more money in 9 years. I made more than I expected, but I'd like to make more. And how could I have taken these great celebrity interviews and monetized them, which it did not. And that's where we're sitting today with who knows where we're going. Maybe I need to go fund me. How many people really enjoy what I do? I was hoping also to have a show that would be easier to produce, have a team of people to do it. And we had it at one point. We don't anymore. And I also was hoping for just a viral process to happen. And it's not. So those are the kind of regrets. Would I change anything? I mean, those are very limited. I wouldn't change anything else. What have I not talked about in this program today, which we're going to close at 55 minutes. There's no way I'm going 58 tonight. I would say nothing else. Radio is an addiction. Television is an addiction. Entertainment is an addiction. It destroys families. It destroys relationships. It destroys everything in between. That is the price that I have to pay for what I've been able to accomplish that many people have not been able to accomplish. The amount of guests, the amount of people, what I've learned in radio is teaching me to present in conferences online or present or doing talks in front of people, which I never would have ever thought I could do 9 years ago, to having the ability to interview anybody or be interviewed by anybody and not have any nerves at all and be able to think on my feet and answer the right questions and provide the right information. It's taught me to talk anytime, anywhere, being able to talk, be able to come up with anything and come up with great taglines and not be afraid to talk, all because of this experience. It's taught me exactly how to tell a story better than ever. And to look at my audience as something very special. It is the greatest thing in the world when you go in front of people, introduce yourself. I'm nationally syndicated radio host Neil Haley. I've interviewed celebrities X, Y, and Z, and you could Google me today. That's something that no one else will ever take away, and it's worth its weight in gold. So all of these things are thanks to the day that I walked into WRCT Studios in 2010. Yeah. Yes, it definitely is 2010. No, 2009. What am I thinking? 2009, December 6th with my wife, Jennifer Haley. And we did a podcast / pilot. And where we are today is just amazing. But I told you this has been a roller coaster ride my whole entire existence in 9 years, but it's something I can't walk away from ever. But as I told you, all the skill sets that I've been taught thanks to doing this, it's amazing. There's no way ever to the experience that I've gained from this. So for people listening that say, I want to do my own radio show, I'm telling you, it's like, I'm thinking about doing a podcast. Here's the thing. If you don't want to be the best, if you don't want to move mountains, get the heck out of Dodge. Don't even come into my playground. But if you really, truly want to, I'd love to mentor you. If you truly want to be passionate, you'll get up and say at 10 o'clock at night on December 27th and do an hour show to just reminisce on what you've done. You truly have this, but you got to have this passion. It doesn't matter what kind of money. This is a passion that you can't replace, and you got to do it because it's worth its weight in gold. It's worth its weight, and it's also worth just an experience that you'll tell your grandkids when everyone else is kind of out of the house and your kids have had kids, and you sit down and say, Grandpa, what did you do for a living? And you talk to them, and they listen for hours on end saying, really? That in itself will show you've lived a life with a purpose, entertainment-wise. I'm not telling you I lived the life outside of entertainment that's so flashy. It's not. But in purposes of my experiences since 2009 or when I've walked in a wrestling ring, I've lived the life that no one else has lived. Many people have lived. And I really, this kind of taken the cake because most people after their professional wrestling career never kind of rebrand, but I'm much more successful in this. But my goal is to be as successful and 10 times more successful as an entrepreneur and to bring amazing people to my life. in entrepreneurship. My entrepreneurship's taking a little bit of a derail as well, and I'm working with some companies now as consulting and working in other ways. But that's, again, as I talked about, it's a roller coaster ride. You never know where you're going to go. So remember, check me out on Twitter at Total Tutor, Neil S. Haley, Facebook, LinkedIn, Neil Haley, Instagram, Total Tutor, Pinterest, Neil Haley, and Google Plus, which I've not been posting and I need to. Check me out on all different platforms, 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. And I want to thank you guys. We're not going to reminisce anymore about these 9 years. The 10th year is going to be exciting, and it all starts in January. I might record a couple more times before the end of the year, but it all starts in January. And this January is going to start slow and finish really strong, because I just believe in this product more than ever. And I'm never giving up on this. And I already have game plans. Once I have all my entrepreneurial things in place, to have an exciting 2019. And I know I will, because I will never give up on this dream. And never give up on your dreams at all as well, guys. And we'll talk very, very soon. Check me out on all syndication. We will re-air a lot of different shows all the way till 2019. We don't stop. Never, never, never. And then 2019 is a big exciting. And for the first time ever, when the ball drops 2019, this is just really a point where I want to walk out and throw 2018 out the window. And I'm excited as heck for 2019. Take care, guys. Talk next week. Or we'll talk tomorrow. Good day, everyone.